I like your hat troll because it's just Joe. I mean, I get a lot of people that troll, but it's like one of the other day, this guy's like trolling in my videos, and I think it's funny, dude.
What's the meanest thing somebody ever said to you?
Oh gosh, for me, about how I overcame the struggles with alcohol and beer. You know, in 2014, I was at complete rock bottom, drinking beer every day. I vividly remember going out like on a Saturday, nothing to do, and getting like a 20 pack of bottles of Coors Light beer, coming home and drinking the beers on the couch, wanting to go out and do something, and I just drink the beers at home. And this went on, but it didn't go on too long. I stopped it, but I found myself in that predicament March 31st of 2014, that I came down back here to the A's game. I'm at Oakland Coliseum right here behind me. And I had this big day planned. It's the opening day of the game. And I wanted to go down there and bring my girl I was dating down there. Prior to that, I bought these tickets for opening day. They were great tickets. I was like, I can't wait to go. It's going. Ended up, leaving me, bringing another girlfriend of mine, Sarah Thomas. We had a great time, came down here and enjoyed the game. It was a night game. Never forget, I was drank beers the whole time here, got drunk, came back, drank more at home. And so I woke up that day, April 1st, the day after this big hangover, after literally a 30-day hangover. I've been drinking every day for 30 days, drinking beer of some kind, something every day for 30 days, at least. And I woke up and I said, you know what? I'm mad. I'm not gonna drink today. Today's the day, I'm not drinking. I'm gonna go walk instead, maybe do some exercise. The next day I said the same thing. Today's the day, I'm not gonna drink. Walk around, do some more exercise. I said, you know what? This week, I'm gonna get through this week. This week right here, I'm not gonna drink this week, this entire week. And it was weird, it was hard at that point. I said, I'm gonna do it. But I'm gonna go ahead and start training hard. I'm gonna start training my body. I'm gonna get in shape. You know, having fat around my stomach and unhappy. And I started training. I was like, okay, I'm gonna do it. I made it a week. And I said, you know what? I'm gonna make this 21 days. I'm gonna do it. That's it, period. I'm going to make 21 days. I know I can do it. And I started training. I started physically exerting myself, doing activity, getting high from endorphins of the training every single day. As opposed to drinking. And I made it to 21 days. And then after 21 days, I said, you know what, I'm gonna make it 30 days. I'm gonna do it, and that's it, period. I'm gonna get to 30 days, no alcohol, no beer. I know I can do it. I made it to 30 days, and it was a big deal. At this point in 30 days, I still hadn't been able to go out or do anything. Wasn't like able to like be around other people, like socialize around beers or bars. I definitely didn't have the trust in myself yet or the strength to do that. However, what I did do is I set another goal. I said, I'm gonna make it another month, make it to 60 days. And I made it. I started training even more, watching what I eat.
Hello, how are you?
Hello.
this is my train right here. That's my train. Oh yeah. So this time I'm not gonna miss my train, dude. I'm gonna get off on the right stop. So I started training physically every day, making it like a fun game of like watching what I would eat. Here's the bar schedule. And working in that challenge of doing that. And then I set another goal, and I said, I'm gonna get to 90 days, dude. I'm gonna get to 90 freaking days. I'm gonna do it, and that's it, period. 90 days. And by the time I reached the 90-day point, I feel like at that 90-day point, that was like the breakthrough for me. Having me, okay? We'll see you next time. I'm out of here. Left early. Okay, guys, thanks for having me. Sorry for setting off the alarm with the phone and everything.
Bye.
Well, there's a security gate. You gotta check your phone, I guess. Alarms keep going off, man. Wow. Get beers out here.
Well, beer, guys.
Very nice. Like anybody can get beers out here any age. You just buy them. Selling beers to anybody, kids and all. Just buy a beer. When I have you by my side. Every single day brings freedom. And there's no worry clouds inside. Yeah, I know. I believe. I finally found that place in me that's higher. Beginning to edit that video, I realized the sound was choppy, so I'm picking up where I left off down here in downtown Berkeley right now. I just got off on the BART station, and so I set a 90-day goal. After that, a 90-day goal was next, and then my 90-day goal was a big milestone for me in not drinking and not having beer, because that 90-day goal, I feel like, was the first time that I could then go out and begin to like socialize around people and be around bars, be around parties or social events and gatherings, when there was beer around and alcohol around, not be tempted. I feel like that was my breakthrough moment. That 90-day period was just huge. So from that point, I had really had a crystallized, a long-term goal of like the aesthetic physique that I wanted, and I completely replaced that old habit of drinking and sitting on the couch drinking those beers and that alcohol with physically working on the body and going after that perfect aesthetic Z's physique. And I'm on the train earlier, and I'm meeting with this guy. I see this guy with a hat, Troll, Jesse, and he asks me, he says, what's your favorite sport? Like, what do you like to do? So I'm going to the A's game. I'm thinking, well, you know, I used to play baseball, and I used to swim, and I do love those sports, and I believe they brought a lot of joy to myself. I even did wrestling. I think there's a lot of joy in that, but I really believe and I love aesthetics as a sport. And the aesthetics to me is like improving the body's health, improving the body's physical overall appearance, you know, to make it more healthier, okay, overall, more agile, you know, more youthful. It's overall personal aesthetics. And yeah, you could consider it somewhat of a bodybuilding, but not competing in any way. Competing against yourself, your own goals that you have. I'll tell you, so I told Jesse, I said, you know, it's about like, I actually physically was able to see my body change. You know, seeing the body change made all the difference in the world. There's a band playing down here, Berkeley. Anything goes in Berkeley, man. Anything. No rules here. Berkeley, man. Like, you could do anything you want, bro. You got a nice body. Thank you, I said. Yeah. So back to like the aesthetics, like what it's done. It's created this incredible way that the body looks. And by transforming, like making that like my sport, making that my obsession, I'm actually able to, like, the results that I put in, I can see them. I love that. I never could see the joy. I mean, I could feel the joy from the other sports that I did, but seeing the long-term lasting results of, like, my skin becoming healthier. And for the guys who, I've seen comments about saying, oh, you know, your skin is definitely Botox on there, or shots in the skin. When you have Botox or shots in your skin, you can't smile and squint in your eyes. And if you notice, you see that? My eyes move. There's no, see that? There's movement. That's what it is. I just don't have the wrinkles, man. You know, like I said, a number of other factors I've talked to on this channel. But if you notice, see that? It moves. My face is not frozen. Frozen face. Yeah, see that? That means I haven't had Botox or any shots. You know, you may say that it's very narcissistic to try to improve your body and look better, all right? And that's fine. You want to believe that, you can believe that. But I believe in the only way that I can, I really believe that the only way that I can help others and make an impact on the world, okay, and an impact on humanity, improving the world for the good, is I believe I've got to personally improve myself. I've got to personally improve myself. And the first thing I do when I go to a doctor, I'm going to look at somebody, learn from them. I want to see what they look like, man. I want to see their skin. I want to see, if I'm going to learn about health, I want to see their physical body. I want to see their abs. Yeah, I want to see their aesthetics. Because if they're a master and they're teaching me about the body, then I want to make sure they've been able to master themselves. And for all the guys who want all this proof about human growth hormone going up 2,000%, the truth is that, man, the only proof is in experience. There's never been a true human clinical trial published in peer-reviewed journals on humans before and after. And why would there? It's too expensive. So there is no physical medical proof. I don't doubt there ever will be. You have to experience it yourself. You know, and by experiencing it, you know, your life will change. And so do the like button like this. There's a little bell down below by my picture. I'm gonna say, where you see subscribe. There's a little bell, notification bell. Hit that bell. So every time I make a new video, you're gonna get notified about it. Every time I make a video, it's not just wasting time. There's a purpose behind it. There's something you're gonna get out of it. You're gonna get something out of it. Value that will help you in one way or another, okay? Along, that's helped my journey, that's gonna help you. So definitely hit that bell. Leave a comment below any questions you have or thoughts that you may have on this issue. And I hope that it added value, how I overcame struggles with alcohol and beer and replaced it with a new obsession, a new passion. Health and wellness, aesthetics, fitness. Hope you can do the same. This is Gavin, man. Yeah, no, I like your hat. Troll.
What's the meanest thing somebody ever said to you?
Oh gosh, for me?
Potentially trying to hurt somebody.
No, it's not. It's like I look at it like being out on the playground, like in high school, or whatever, and like guys say something funny to get a laugh, and it may be kind of mean, but it doesn't really. It's not personal. It's just like more to get a laugh. What the meanest thing any troll had ever said to me was? I tend to block it out. I don't remember. Okay. If I was an A's fan, I said, well, not really. I'm going for the sun. That's my old thing. Want to get some sun. Yeah.